morning. My name is Rithia Terrell, and my question is, to what extent does ocean acidification affect Pacific coral reefs in the past 20 years, in which I will be arguing that that ocean acidification negatively affects Pacific coral reefs? As the effects of ocean acidification increase, the health of the oceans has concerned the scientific community more and more. As shown by this graph, there is an increase in atmospheric CO2 and a decrease in seawater pH. According to NOAA, the decreased pH is what causes ocean acidification. One effect that ocean acidification causes is coral bleaching. Coral bleaching happens when the zooxanthella, which is the algae that gives corals its color, leaves its tissues. This happens when corals get stressed. They usually get stressed if there are unusually high or low temperatures, or if the acidity of the water increases. This then leads to bleached coral. Though bleached coral does not mean that the coral is dead, because the conditions of the water are not improving, they become deceased. According to the NOAA, the rainforests are the organisms. Oceans are the rainforests of the sea, and coral bleaching, which is the trees of the rainforest, would cause coral reefs to become deceased. Another effect ocean acidification has is the breakdown of shells. According to the Smithsonian, it is harder for shells to evolve in acidic environments. This is because the lower pH causes the calcium carbonate to dissolve quickly. As shown by this diagram, in the course of 45 days, a shell has gone from healthy to disformed. Shells are needed for protection, and if the shells are becoming deformed, coral reef creatures will have a higher chance of being eaten and lead to their extinction. According to the Smithsonian, some organisms grow even stronger shells under higher acidity. However, according to Rob Dunbar, a professor at Woods Institute, to find a time when CO2 levels are about the same as today, one would have to go back 15 million years. This graph shows the time period of 1,000 temperatures over 1,000 years, and as you can see, 2009 has been the highest out of all of them. This shows that organisms have not been adapted to high temperatures and will therefore not be able to survive ocean acidification. Another effect is the physiology of marine animals. According to the New Food Economy, one can taste acidification in mussels, and this would therefore lead to the conclusion that that the physiology is also affected. As shown by this graph, some effects of CO2 on fish is sensory. The sensory effects then lead to direct effects, such as increased predation on fish. This will then lead to food web effects, which will affect the coral reefs as a whole. Some might say that plastics have a bigger effect on the coral reefs than ocean acidification does. As shown by this graph, there are 6,350 to 245,000 metric tons of plastic in coral reefs. And according to the UN Environmental Program, in a survey of 159 corals, there was in the Asia Pacific region, there was estimated to be 11.1 billion tons of plastics entangled in coral reefs. There are billions of plastics affecting coral reefs every day, so one can see why that you could conclude that plastics are affecting more than ocean acidification. However, we have seen the effects of plastics ever since the late 1970s, and according to the Smithsonian, studies on ocean acidification only started in 2003. This means that ocean acidification is a relatively new concept that scientists have stumbled upon, and it's chemically changing our oceans. Plastic is something physical that, for the most part, can be picked up by new technologies, but it would be really hard to come up with a technology that can chemically change the pH of the entire ocean. The solution to ocean acidification is to simply lower carbon emissions. That is the only way that we can decrease the acidity of the water. As shown by this graph, the estimated U.S. average 5 times the global average of 4 metric tons. This shows the dependency we have on carbon. Our reliance on carbon is killing corals, and we have to defend for them before it's too late. In the words of marine biologist Christian Marlowe, the best time to protect coral reefs was 50 years ago. The second best time to protect them is right now. Thank you. What questions do you have?
All right, 2 new questions for you. Back up a little bit if you would. Thank you. Here you go. First one, how valid and reliable were the sources you used, and then how do you know they were?
All my sources, for the most part, were big organizations such as NOAA or Smithsonian, and they're big sources that have a name. And my other sources were from college professors that work at prestigious institutions.
Okay, and then what advice would you have for other researchers that consider this topic?
So my evidence was on coral reefs, and everything that I researched, one way or another, because it's in an ecosystem, was all affecting each other. So, like, for example, when I went to my source on shelf organisms, it talked about coral reefs. So that's how I know they were both impacted. So everything's very much related, and you can always find an abundance of information on this topic.
You're done. You can breathe.